business that you think have relevance to the South African perspective?
Well, I think firstly, the question's broken. We're not South African. The minute we position ourselves as South African, we sit in this place that we think we're not as good enough to play in the world. I did a keynote recently called We Are Not African, We Are Global Citizens. The trends that are applying across the world is what we need to keep our eyes on. South Africa is an emerging country, like India, like China, like Brazil. Those trends are relative in all those places. And I think the number one thing we need to do is get our attitude right into believing that we're global players and just start playing on that global field. Besides that, all other trends you can research. Once you get that headspace right, the rest of it's easy.
From innovation to disruption, yes. What next?
Wow. And from innovation to disruption, I think what next is we're going to settle into seamlessness. I think the world we're moving into is really going to be all about hyper-convenience all around us. And when we start having an intelligent, ambient world with IP addresses talking to each other, creating seamless for us, once we settle in and accept this future that we're moving into, I think we move into a space of absolute seamlessness. And abundance, let me add that, because I think it's abundance and seamlessness. And the world has never been in a better position. More people are being educated than ever before. That's just going to rise. Less people are dying from disease than ever before. More women are being educated than ever before. We're just on such an amazing trajectory. And it's really up to us to stop watching Crisis News Network, CNN, so that we're not always panicking and start to really focus and start to look at the ways that we can uplift people around us using technology and the right mindset.
So do you think this speaks to us moving towards the light, as you so poignantly pointed out?
Well, you see, I think most of us have gotten to the point where we think anxiousness is normal. You know, when our legs tapping up and down like this all the time, we think that's normal. It's not normal. The fact that we always in a space of anxiousness as a benchmark of emotion is something that's been learnt. It's the world we've built around us that it's never enough. We need to be bigger, faster, and that continuous need for more recognition is based on an immature emotional state. We have to mature out of it and start running towards the light and away, not away from the darkness.
What is the risk of keeping ahead of the game?
What is the risk of not keeping ahead of the game? I mean, it's obvious. When you're not keeping ahead of the game, when you're not asking questions that make you feel uncomfortable, what you're going to start doing is doing the same thing you always did. And that becomes the most dangerous thing moving into this future. And the question you need to be asking yourself is, are you living a life based on a set of memories from the past, or are you living a life based on the vision of your future? Your past is irrelevant. Where you're going is everything. That's all we want to know. We want to build on that vision of where you're going. What happened yesterday and the day before, nobody really cares. It's gone. It's never going to happen again.